How's it going, everyone? YouTuber Corey here, aka Crasher, back with a new video, and ladies and gentlemen, we are back with another discussion video in regards to Twitch, because it seems like once again, Twitch did something to piss people off, so let's see what we have here. Just an FYI before we begin, I am in full agreement with the outrage here. Now, let's begin. So let's dive into this article on Dexero that is titled, Twitch Criticized for Selling ViewBots with Stream Boost Feature as Pay to Win. Oh my god. Twitch has announced plans to allow viewers to boost streams with payments in an effort to elevate smaller channels. However, the initiative has been met with swift backlash among the community, with it being labeled selling ViewBots. In 2021, Twitch has made several changes affecting both creators and viewers alike. These include several different features, including lower sub prices for viewers in other countries, as well as adding phone number verification options to combat the ongoing hate raid issues. On Twitch's Patch Notes stream on September 30th, DJ Wheat was joined by product manager Jacob Rosak, who told viewers about the boost feature. Communities want us to make boosts more available, and second, communities want us to make it more impactful, Rosak said. We're going to be running a small experiment over the next few weeks with a select group of creators. In this experiment, we allow viewers to directly purchase boost for their favorite creators. This new feature would essentially allow viewers to pay for a streamer to get more exposure on the site by recommending the channel to more people. Twitch's intention is to help grow smaller communities. However, this isn't an idea that many other streamers appear to be on board with. Some have called it pay to win, and others argue that it will actually benefit streamers who have a big fan base to start with, as they will have more viewers willing to pay. YouTuber Captain Sauce called it the grossest thing I've seen any new media platform do. Partnered streamer Nacy called the idea exploitative. SodaPoppin, who has over 3 million followers on Twitch, also mocked the proposal, joking that no one cares about smaller streamers and that he will be boosting his channel to stay ahead. Longtime streamer Co Carnage, another big streamer on Twitch, who was one of the first members of Twitch's Safety Advisory Council, said he didn't have the words to explain how much he disliked this direction. Some have even pointed out that this new feature might in fact go against Twitch's own guidelines, which state it is prohibited to resell Twitch services or features. Right now, this function is only being run as a small test, so potentially, given the backlash, it may be shelved by Twitch following the test period. Okay, so now that we've resolved the context on the table, allow me to open up by saying, yeah, this right here definitely comes off very much so as pay to win. And I feel like I'm getting deja vu here because we deal with that when it comes to Pokemon Go, when it comes to Niantic's antics, because while Pokemon Go might be free to play, it is pay to win. Let's keep that straight. And while Twitch may be free to stream, this right here honestly very much comes off as pay to win, or in this instance, pay to grow or pay to be promoted, which in translation is a form of winning. And something like this is very, very flawed because based on the details right here, it seems like it's more in favor of those who are rich and or have a massive fan base, because you could either boost yourself to be recommended even more on the Twitch site, or you will have much higher chances of your own fan base boosting you up as well, so that way you could have more recommendations on Twitch. And I know that Twitch every now and then has a bit of a history of making moves that are either questionable or downright stupid, but this right here, honestly, has got to be one of the most stupidest moves I have ever seen. The timing of this is also quite problematic because Twitch, do I need to remind you that there is still a massive issue with hate raids on the site? Because here's the thing, is that not only does it cause overall problems for the structure and the integrity of the site itself, but above that, it is affecting the streamers and the viewers alike. And that is something that unanimously, I don't think anyone is going to stand for. But it seems like Twitch in this situation cares more about finding ways to make more money off of their site and the viewers and creators, rather than focusing more on the safety and the mental health and well-being of everyone that frequents the site. So, good job. Little golf clap right there, you know? Just little golf clap. So sarcasm aside, I hope that Twitch is able to understand that the community is very, very much against us. Even the big streamers that could have easily benefited off of this, they are calling this out as a bad idea. So Twitch, if you have the ability to count to four and tie your shoes and your ABCs as well, then you would definitely trash this idea. It is not good. But ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the day, these are just my own opinions and takeaways from this. What do you guys think about what it is we discussed here in today's video? I would love to hear you guys out, whether you agree or disagree with my points. You know I always love to hear you guys out. Just make sure you keep them respectful and keep them straight up in the comments. That's all I ask. Thank you guys very much for watching. Thank you very much for your time as well in viewing this video. Have yourself a damn good one, guys, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next video.